Today's episode is a photography episode. It's going to be a little project to build a studio in a garage with a few Manfrotto components that I've had over the years that have been stacked away. And it's probably an affordable way to do it compared to building a full complete one with plasterboard and doing the curves and stuff like that. It's just going to be a basic paper backdrop and we'll go from there. So this is going to be the wall, and I've got to put a steel Z-purlin in, and that's going to be cut and bolted for the Manfrotto posts to go in. And then we'll test photograph a motorcycle, and I'll show you my camera settings when I do that. But this has been in the works for a number of years, and I finally got to the point where I have a garage and to make a working studio for product photography. So let's go. And then I divide that by 2. The other thing I find putting a Z-purlin in, the benefit of the lip being out on the base of that Z-purlin, I'll be able to clip fabric material. So a black backdrop in fabric or any green for green screen. That was a leftover piece of construction material, which is the added benefit. So that's where I'm saving some money. So I don't have to buy it. So I'm using what I had left over from the build. Okay. So let's cut this out with an angle grinder, and then we'll look at installing it at a certain height. Always wear eye protection and earmuffs. I'm not a huge fan of cutting metal, but those sparks go everywhere. Okay, back to the studio.
So test fit.
Level, does it? Yeah, okay. I'm going to need 2 pieces of timber cut to 2.4 to hold it up. Thank you. twist it. So, as long as it doesn't fall on my head. Perfect. Okay. Just going to fix these in with tech screws. Two each end. One, two. Yeah, it should just hold. Four should be good. Problem. It's been a while since I've used this backdrop and the paper is actually bowed. That's why. Funny. So if we're sausage. Okay. Aperture make this light. I think what the brand, the actual product code, or ALH198C. Did do a video on these ages ago, but I want to show you that you can use them as a fuel light for studio work. Small rig maker, small little, I think they're called a C clamp, and I'm gonna fix this to this. Well, it's pretty much, it's like using a hair light when you do portrait photos of people. So, but you can also use it for product photography. Come up here and I'll show you how it's set up. It's clamped on to the Z channel and you can adjust it. I'm trying to do this with one hand. So I can turn it and angle it onto the product or person, and then you just tighten it off. And Bob's your uncle. So that's the benefit of having this rail across the top of the rolls of paper here. So I'm gonna photograph the bike, but because it's such a nice day, I think I'm gonna go for a ride. But this is the studio setup, the basics first stage setup. Hopefully I can do some more stuff later on. And I can do two types of test shots, one with a white backdrop and then the other do the industrial look with the silver, because the silver would look good with the silver tank. And we'll see. I've got to get the lights out, and the other thing is I don't have power in this garage yet, and it would be good if I had the Sparky out to fix that, but I might run a power lead and a power board and set up the studio lights, which I haven't done for a while, and that's the Elinchrom kit. It's been a really good kit for flash photography. But we'll come back. I'm going for a ride. Too nice of a day to sit here and photograph this when I can go outside and take advantage of the sun. The studio lights are the Elinchrom BX500RI, long discontinued, but they have done their job and lasted for over a decade, which is not bad considering how long I've had these. Get the studio is not wide enough, really. That backdrop's not wide enough to get a whole bike in. So I have to look at other solutions. It's not ideal. We just test shots, not. It's something to work on. Too much shadow down here. Makes the background wider. Okay, I want to shut. I didn't say what camera that I wanted to do the test shots with. The GFX50s, and in the hot shoes the Elinchrom Skyport. And there's a few limitations on this focal length here. Really, I need to be back another couple of meters for space. Now I'm going to take the shot with the insulation as the background to go with the silver. And we'll see how that looks. I'll do the same, I'll shoot f4 at 1/25th of a second for the shutter speed, and we'll see. 2.3 for the power settings. Very hot. Ooh, that kind of looks cool looking. Let's go back to F4 and it's kind of cool, would be
ideal. But I'll show the JPEG when I edit the video. But it's kind of got an industrial look to it. Probably perfect for motorcycle photography. But yeah, kind of cool. But now I know the direction I'm going with this stuff. So more, I need to go back further with the lights. And I still got to turn and test the lights above on the brackets here, on the Z-Perl one. But there you go. Hopefully more photography stuff in the works. I'll keep you posted.